Chapter 10, Learning Objective 5, describing other types of property and liability insurance. You can buy specialized protection for other loss, types of losses. An umbrella policy covers, is on top of all of your other insurance. That's why it's called an umbrella. It's in addition. If you exceed the limits on any other policy, the umbrella policy would kick in. There's also flood insurance through the National Flood Insurance Program or earthquake insurance provided by various agencies and insurance companies. Most policies exclude or limit flood or and earthquake exposure. Professional liability insurance. If you're starting a business or running a business out of your home, you should probably have personal liability insurance. As you recall from one of the previous lectures, the coverage on homeowners did not apply through the conducting of your own business. Figure 10.3 shows how an umbrella policy covers on top of every other policy that you have. Down at the bottom, we have auto liability, your homeowner's comprehensive liability, and professional liability insurance, and your umbrella liability layers over the top of those, and it gives you, in this case, $1 million in addition to those liability limits that are on your other policies. Another type of specialized insurance is floater policy. Floater top policies cover movable items. They might cover a trailer, ATV, or anything of that nature. They also cover any kind of tools required for your work. Concept check 10.5 explains how purchasing a policy, an umbrella policy, applies to the large loss principle. Umbrella policies cover, losses in excess of those covered by any underlying policies. So they're insuring large losses. They're not going to pay you for your small losses, because those small losses will either be applied to deductibles or covered by other policies. Umbrella policies are going to apply to large significant losses. If you're preparing for a professional career, how would you protect yourself from such losses, especially if you're conducting business in your own home? Professional liability insurance is appropriate, because as I mentioned, this homeowners is not going to cover liability arising from work or business being conducted in your home. Give two examples of someone who might want to purchase a floater policy. Floater policies cover losses related to movable property. Like a couple of examples: mechanics, tools, or a fifth wheel. Those would both be covered under a floater policy. Learning objective 6, how to make a claim, an insurance claim. Contact your insurance agent, document your loss, file your claims. When you file your claims, you're going to be dealing with the claims adjuster. A lot of times when you deal with a claims adjuster, you have to go get on the phone and make a recorded statement, and you'll likely be under oath when you make that recorded statement. You'll sign a release only when you're satisfied with the settlement from the insurance company. You never want to sign anything before you're satisfied with the settlement. Concept check 10.6, what is the best way to establish documentation for a potential losses to your personal property. Visual inventory, photos or videos of all valuables along with the date of purchase, price paid, model name and number, and serial number. Describe the term of lease and why signing a release too soon might work to your disadvantage. Release absolves the insurance company, or signed release absolves the insurance company of any additional liability. If you sign it too soon, you're going to give away your rights for being reimbursed on that. So you don't want to sign it until you're satisfied that you've been fully reimbursed for your cost. So, worst financial blunders in managing property and liability risk? Buy only the legal minimum required minimum liability coverage for your vehicle. This is, if you've seen the advertisements for the general, this is why their rates are lower. They insure you at the minimum. It's, you know, if that's all you can afford, that's understandable. But if you have any assets that need protecting, you need to buy, pay for much higher liability coverage than the minimum. Number two, pay high premiums because you select low deductibles on property insurance for your home and car. And the large loss principle says to accept the liability that you can and insure the large liabilities that you can. And number three, fail to keep good records, list photos, receipts that could serve to document your property losses. Do it now. You know a little bit more about personal finance and insurance after reading this chapter. You know, identify your exposures to risk and the magnitude of losses that could occur. Assess your automobile insurance cover. Make any changes necessary. Buy renter's insurance if you rent your house.